We cannot become the supreme. At least we don't find in authorized Vedic literature that a living entity can become as powerful as God. No, it is not possible. God is great. He is always great. Even if you are liberated from the material classes, still he is great. That is. Therefore, this verse, Govindam Adipurusam Tamaham Bhajam. Our perpetual relationship with God is to worship him or to serve him. That service is very pleasant. Don't take it as soon as we talk of service, we may think that, we are suffering here by adopting service. Just like the next, the other evening one boy was questioning, why should we bow down? I do not know if he is present here. Bow down to surrender to somebody is not bad, but because we are in a different situation, by surrendering to other, it is very uncomfortable. Just like nobody wants to be dependent on other nation, nobody wants to be dependent on other people. Everyone wants to be independent because this material world is perhaps a reflection of the spiritual world. But in the spiritual world, the more you surrender, the more you are servant, you are happy. You are happy. But we have no such understanding at the present moment. We have no spiritual idea, no spiritual realization. Therefore, we shudder as soon as we hear that we have to become servant of God. There is no question of shuddering. It is very pleasant to become servant of God. You see, so many great reformers, they came. And they serve the mission of God and they are still worship. So to become servant of God, servitor of God, is not very insignificant thing. It is the most important thing. Govindam Adipurusam Tamaham. But don't accept it. First of all, try to understand. Therefore, Vedant Sutra says, Athato Brahma Jigyasa. Try to understand what is Brahma. Why this sound? Try to understand what is Brahma. And try to understand your relationship. And then, when you actually surrender, you will feel your eternal blissful life, full of knowledge, and this is very nicely explained in the teachings of Lord Chaitanya. In the Bhagavad Gita also, the same teaching is there, but we have got two books already published. One Bhagavad Gita as it is, another book, Teachings of Lord Chaitanya. So, Bhagavad Gita teaches surrendering process. Sarva dharmān parityajya māmekam saraṇam. You surrender unto me, the Lord says. And the Lord teaching, Chaitanya Mahāpurusha teaching is how to make surrender. Because we have been accustomed in our present conditional life to revolt against surrender. There are so many parties, so many isms. And the main principle is that why shall I surrender? That is the main disease. Whatever political party is there, just like the Communist Party, their revolt is against the superior authority they call capitalist. Now, why should I? Everywhere, the same thing is, why shall I surrender? But we have to surrender. That is our constitutional position. If I don't surrender to some particular person or particular government or particular community or society or something, but ultimately I am surrendered to the laws of nature. There is no independence. I have to surrender when there is call of the cruel hands of death. For immediately I have to surrender. So many things. So we should understand, this is Brahma Jigyasa, why there is this surrendering process. If I don't like to surrender, then I am forced to surrender. In this state also, if I don't mean to abide by the laws of the state obliges me to surrender by police force, by military force, by something. Similarly, I don't want to die, but death forces me to surrender. I don't want to become old man, but nature forces me to become old. I don't want any disease, but nature forces me to accept some sort of disease. So this surrendering process is there. Now we have to understand why this is so. That means my constitutional position is to surrender. But the present difficulty is that I am surrendering to a wrong person. When we understand that I should surrender to the Supreme Lord, then my constitutional position is revived. That is my liberty.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.